Good afternoon, and welcome to the afternoon worship service of Greater Quinn African Methodist Episcopal Church. We are so blessed and honored that you are joining with us on today, this first Sunday in May. We are located on the historic corner of Rosa Parks and Davidson. Our address, 13501 Rosa Parks Boulevard, and our pastor is the Reverend Robert Blake, and our assistant ministers are Reverend Laura Foster and Reverend Deborah Elliott. As we open up this service, we invite you to join with us in our opening song of worship, How Great is Our God.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how
stand. Let us pray. Oh, how great is our God. You're the name above all names, worthy of all praise. Our hearts will sing, how great is our God. Father God, we come humbly before your throne, just thanking you for your mercy, for your grace, for your protection, for allowing us to gather here together one more time. Father, today is another day to draw closer to you, to receive your knowledge, your wisdom, to receive all the things that you have for us on today, oh God. Father, right now we empty ourselves out of anything that would hinder your spirit and your anointing from flowing in this place. We bind Satan and his attempts and his attacks and his minions and his little whoever's that try to come against us and try to disturb us and try to upset us and try to stop the flow. And we loose your anointing. We loose your healing. We loose your power. We loose your authority, oh God, in this place on today. Father, we touch and agree for those who won't be here on today, for those who may be experiencing illness. We thank you in advance for their healing. Father, for those who are experiencing financial difficulties, we thank you for being our provider, for being all-sufficient in all things, oh God. Father, we thank you for those who may be having trouble in their families. We thank you that you are the head of all things, that your son Jesus is the head of all things, and that he will rule and reign in that situation. We thank you in advance, Father God, for all of your good gifts. All good things come from you, and we look forward to receiving them. Today, God, what we want to focus on is your love. Your love, Father God. You so love that you gave your only beloved son, and for that we are thankful. Father, today we want to think about someone we know in the natural, who we know loves us unconditionally, loves us bountifully. And Father, we want to be reminded that you love us infinitely more than that person. And that love will be what guides us. That love will be what directs us. That love will be what draws us on today, Father God. That love will be the thing that makes the difference, because you so loved that you gave. Father, we thank you for the word that will come forth from our pastor. We look forward to hearing what thus saith the Lord through Robert Blake. Father, we thank you for looking forward to thus saith the Lord as it comes through this music ministry on today, Father God. From the drummer to the organist, from the altos, the sopranos, the tenors, the bass, oh God, we will minister to your people. We will love on your people. We will take what we received today and give it away freely, because you so loved that you gave. You are our example, and we will govern ourselves accordingly. Thank you, O God. Thank you, O God. Thank you, O God. Now continue to have your way in this place. Move from the front to the back, from the top to the bottom, and just flow. Breathe on us, O God, today, so that we can go forward in power and might in the blood and authority of the name of Jesus. All these things we pray in your son Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Somebody ought to tell God. 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 Thank you.
Luke 7:18-23. And the disciples of John shewed him of all these things. And John calling unto him, two of his disciples sent them to Jesus, saying, Art thou he that should come, or look we for another? When the men were come unto him, they said, John Baptist has sent us unto thee, saying, Art thou he that should come, or look we for another? And in that same hour he cured many of their infirmities and plagues and evil spirits. And unto many that were blind, he gave sight. That's a one number. That's a number, honey. That he gave him sight. Then Jesus answering said unto them, Go your way and tell John what things ye have seen and heard. How that the blind see, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised to the poor. The gospel is preached. It is preached. It is preached. And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. Amen. Hallelujah. And amen.
We'll now be blessed by a selection from our music ministry, and following that, a mighty word from our pastor, Robert Blake.
Well, bless the Lord, everybody. Come on and bless the Lord today. Come on and put your hands together. Give God a praise. Come on and thank him. Won't you just thank him today for all that he is and all that he's done for us? Such a wonderful God, such an awesome. Oh, y'all can do better than that. Don't tip him. Come on and give God a praise today. Come on and thank him like you know him. Thank him like he's been good to you. Thank him like he woke you up this morning and started you on your way. Glory to Jesus. So we greet you this afternoon in the precious name and matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who's the head of the church who calls us into the ministry. Amen. To those of you who are here in the sanctuary, for those of you who are watching us on Facebook Live, God bless you. We praise God for you on today. Amen. It is the day that the Lord has made, and we are rejoicing and we're glad. We're just so very glad in it. Amen. If you would, please, you heard the scripture earlier, amen, read by the good doctor, amen, Luke, the 7th chapter, the 18th through the 23rd verse. I want you to go with us again, amen, this time from the Message translation. It is word time, amen, at the greater, amen. Come on, let's honor the Lord. Won't you stand in the house this afternoon as we read Luke, the 7th chapter, the 18th through the 23rd verses in the Message translation. In the Message translation, we find these words. John's disciples reported back to him the news of all these events taking place. He sent two of them to the master to ask the question, "Are you the one we've been expecting, or are we still waiting?" The men showed up before Jesus and said, "John the Baptizer sent us to ask you, are you the one we've been expecting, or are we still waiting?" Verse 20, verse 21, "In the next 2 or 3 hours, Jesus healed many from diseases, distress, and evil spirits. To many of the blind, he gave the gift of sight." Then he gave his answer, "Go back and tell John what you have just seen and heard. The blind see, the lame walk, lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, the wretched of the earth have God's salvation, hospitality extended to them. Is this what you were expecting? Then count yourselves fortunate." For a few moments, we want to speak to you from this subject, expectation of the miraculous. Expectation of the miraculous. Let's pray. God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, through the power of your shed blood, we just want to tell you thank you for this moment, for the privilege, for the opportunity to declare your word. God, in the name of Jesus, come on now. Give us revelation knowledge, that which we seek, that which we need to have in this moment. Grant us minds to conceive, hearts to believe, and ears to receive the spoken word of God. Grant us accuracy in preaching, teaching, and speaking, and grant us accuracy in hearing. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray right now, God, that you would do you in us right now, that we can declare a sure word unto your people. Now, Father, not unto us, but unto your name, give glory for your mercy and your truth's sake. Nothing more, nothing less. Oh God, nothing else. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray. Every heart agreed and said, yes, and thank you, and praise the Lord. The expectation of the miraculous. Last week, while I was was pondering about this week's word, I just began to write things down, and it's uncut. I ain't no chaser with this. And I looked at it again, and I'm like, take it or leave it. We grew up in religion. We grew up to be religious. But in the midst of growing up in our religion and being religious, and it's good, it's okay. It happened to all of us. We were taught to have hope and to have faith and to be faithful. But in the midst of all of that, I need you to hear me now. In the midst of all of that, we weren't really taught how to expect from God. If I may use this term word, crapshoot. Maybe he will. Maybe he won't. We are subject to life. Watch this. And not life subject to us. It's what religion taught us. It taught us, watch, to place everything in the hands of God. Some people get blessed, some don't. Some people get healed, some don't. Our expectations are low because of somebody else's experience or even our own. One said, if you don't expect much, you won't have to be disappointed much. Expectations are about really how we feel. And so when you listen to people talk about having expectations, they're low. If I make my expectations low, then I don't have to worry about failing. Expectations. And so Sunday after Sunday, the church gathers together to do what they call worship. And even then, watch this, there's no expectation. Listen to me this morning, or this afternoon. Because if there were, then we wouldn't have to leave church and say, wow, oh boy, didn't we have church today? Watch, like it's some anomaly. Hear me now, that the Spirit of God would want to show up. No expectations. We expect to see our friends. We expect to have conversation. We expect to gossip. We expect to look around and check out on folk. That's our expectation. But no expectation that God will do what he's always done, and that show up. Can I help you this afternoon? He showed up before you got up. He showed up when your feet touched the floor. He showed up before you were able to wash up. He showed up before you were able to put on your clothes. He showed up when he allowed you to walk out of your house. He showed up, I tell you. When you got in the car, he showed up, which allowed you to make your way into the house of the Lord. He showed up because he has expectations of us every day. You ever think about that? What does God expect of me today? We do a lot of hoping, but not really expecting. One say, well, preacher, what's the difference? Hope deals with our feelings. Expectation deals with our knowledge. We hope for a lot of things, but it's not expectation. We grew up religious. That's why sometimes we leave everything to the preacher. Let the preacher know the scriptures. Let the preacher pray. Because the expectation is, and let the preacher get everybody saved. Can I help you? Watch this. Watch this. Your preacher is a religious term versus your pastor. Pastor speaks of relationship. Preacher speaks of religion. Let the preacher do it. Watch, watch. That's what we pay him or her for. I don't need to know how to pray, but for so much. I don't need to learn the scriptures, but that's what he or she is for. Huh? That's what we pay them for. Can I help you this afternoon? Can I let you know this? That's what you might pay him or her for, but all of us are on the same payroll. Every member or follower or disciple or believer, every officer, every deacon, every elder, every trustee, every steward, every layperson, all of us, my God in heaven, are on the same payroll. That's who we are. But low expectations. Watch. Expectations. Wanting more, believing more, watch, desiring that which seems to be beyond you. Expectation. The dictionaries description of it is this: to look forward to regard as likely to happen, anticipate the occurrence of, the coming of, to look out for, to await. Expectation. I said the difference between that and hope was, hope, we're just feeling a thing. I hope it happens. I hope it goes through. I hope we get the money. Hope. Just a feeling. Expectation suggests that something is happening and I'm waiting for it right now. I'm going to get it. And so in this lesson today, we're talking about the expectation of the miraculous. Next week, if the Lord says so, we'll talk about expectation of service. But expectation this week of the miraculous, what? What's it all about? It's about a God who has always been who he's always been and done what he's always done. And that's for all of us, to be a supernatural God, the creator of the ends of the earth. All of us, we were on the phone the other day, weren't we, Lady Di, weren't we, Sister Sunshine? All of us, we were talking about, Dr. Lord, we were talking about, we were miracles. How God had blessed and how God had worked us and how he had healed us. We're all miracles. We are the excellence of God when it comes to him performing miracles. Expectation. And he's always done miracles, hasn't he? And he worked through humankind. Let me give you some information, then I'll sit down. Watch. God always intervenes in our stuff. He always intervenes in our this. And he uses folk to do it. We talk about miracles. We look at Moses. Moses had 38 miracles associated with him. We've been talking about Moses in Bible class. We know about the 9 plagues from chapter 10 through 14, but we also find that Moses prayed and brought quail to the people. Exodus 16, you can write them down if you want. I'll try to go slower. 16, 11 through 13, he brought manna to the people. Exodus 16, 14, and 15. He turned bitter water sweet in Exodus 15, 23 through 25. He got water from a rock. Exodus 17, 1 through 6. Miriam, she got to run her mouth on the wrong dude, was turned leprous in the name of Jesus, then healed in Numbers 12. Fire consumed 250 men because they rose up against Moses. They were rebellious and began to offer incense and ask this question of Moses: who put you in charge? Sometimes we find that in church: who put you in charge? And Moses had to say, y'all come on out to the tent in the morning. I'm going to show you who put me in charge. Hallelujah. 250 men were consumed by fire. Hallelujah. The earth opened up and swallowed Korah and his men in Numbers 16, 28, 33. A plague killed 14,700 people, but was stayed because the priest of the Lord went before God and said, don't do it no more. Moses appeared on the Mount of Transfiguration in Luke, the 9th chapter, the 28th through the 36th verse. Moses, hallelujah, had miracles associated with him. Elijah, 11 miracles associated with him. No rain in 1 Kings 17:1. Supplied oil and meal continuously to a widowed woman. 1 Kings 17:13 and 16. Raised the dead. 1 Kings 17:17 through 23. prayed fire down from heaven. 1 Kings 18:17 through 38. Ended a 3-year drought. 1 Kings 18:41 through 46. Fed two miraculous meals for a 40-day trip to sustain him in 1 Kings 19 and 48. Fed by ravens in 1 Kings 12, 17 and 2 and 7. Called fire down, watch, to burn up soldiers. Hallelujah. That was interesting. Can I help you out? Because, hallelujah, the king had told Elijah, the king had told his men, go tell Elijah to come see me and you go get him. And so the first man came with 50 soldiers. Hallelujah. And Elijah said, if I'm the man of God, let fire come down and burn you up. Burned him up. Another soldier came. The king wants to see you. Hallelujah. Elijah said, if I'm the man of God, let fire burn you up. They burned him up. The next king, the next soldier came, but he came correct. I started crying and laughing all at the same time because he came. Evidently, he heard what had happened, and he came, and he hit the ground and began to worship and said, please have mercy on me. I don't want to be burned up. Spare my life. I'm just delivering the mail, baby. Please help me. Don't hate the messenger. Hallelujah. He parted the Jordan River and walked across on dry ground and was taken to heaven by a whirlwind in a chariot of fire. We're talking about the miraculous today, and met with Moses, hallelujah, and Jesus on the Mount of Transfiguration. Elisha, 15 miracles. Elisha, he parted the Jordan River. He healed water with the source of salt. Hallelujah. He caused 42 children, watch, don't hate, to be torn up by bears because he wasn't going to be disrespected by no bad mouth children. After they've been mocking him, called him bald headed and stuff. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Miracle now. Water supplied for the kings of Israel, Judah, and Edom, for their army and livestock. In 2 Corinthians 3:14 and 20, healed the Shunammite woman that she might have a child and then raise that same child up from the grave. Hallelujah. In 2 Kings 4:32 and 37, healed Naaman of leprosy. 2 Kings 5:1 through 14, made an iron axe head float, hallelujah, to the top of the, hallelujah, surface. In 2 Kings 6:4 and 7, took his servant and said, Lord, open up his eyes that he might see what I can see. There's an army and there's more with us than with them. Allowed him to see. We're talking about miracles now. We're talking about Elisha, hallelujah, who struck the seeing army blind in 2 Kings 6 and 18, then prayed for their eyes to be opened so he could lead them into captivity in 2 Kings 6, 19 and 20. And the boy was so anointed and God had so blessed him that when he died and they threw his grave, himself into a, threw his body into a pit, they threw another man into the pit that was dead and the man came back to life. We're talking about the miraculous this morning. What is your expectation today? What is your expectation from God? Not only was it Elijah and Moses and Elisha, but 10 miracles associated with Peter. He raised the dead. Hallelujah. He lifted the man at the gate of Beautiful. He said, look, I don't have silver and gold, but I do expect God to do his name and to do what he did through us, and lifted him up. Peter not only did miracles, but so did Paul. Paul also had 11 miracles associated with him. He too raised the dead, was bit by a viper, but he lived. Hallelujah. Saw the power of the Spirit of God rest on his own self because he had a vision of Jesus. We're talking about expectation of the miraculous. Well, what does that mean for me? It means I ought to be looking forward for God to do something wonderful in these last days. Can I help you this afternoon? The Bible says in these last days that men and women are going to wax worse and worse. But can I help you this afternoon? They might do that, but it didn't say nothing that God wouldn't help you out in the meantime. You see, if he's the God where the Bible says, I change not, then you can be sure that even in these last days, the miraculous is going to happen for you and I. In these last days, he's going to show up if you will show out. If you can believe it and expect God to do it, he will do it. Can I close this thing out? You see, we talked about Elisha and Elijah. We talked about Moses and Paul and Peter. But can I help you today? Because Jesus, when you look in the Word, there are about 43 miracles attributed to Jesus. Jesus raised the dead. Jesus opened blind eyes. Jesus healed the leprous man. Jesus walked on the water. Jesus fed 5,000, not just once, but he did it twice. Jesus got up from the grave. That was a miracle in itself. He's still the God of the supernatural. He's still the God of the miraculous. He's still the God that is the yes God and the amen God. He's still the God, I tell you. He's still the God. What are you expecting? What are you expecting? Can I close on this story there? And you know the story. You've heard the story, all Sunday school folk. There's a woman, the Word of God says, had an issue of blood. The Bible says it was Mark that she spent all that she had. That the doctors had taken advantage of her. Issue of blood. Meaning because of the law, she shouldn't be out in public. Issue of blood. Meaning that she was constantly watched unclean. Issue of blood. Meaning that she was the least of these. Issue of blood. But you know what? Desperation will make you expect something. Maybe the church ought to become more desperate than it is. That we might expect something. Can I help you? Don't get mad at me. But when stuff ain't going right, what you do? The first thing you do is you be praying. All night long. You be praying. Day in and day out, believing God. You start having prayer conferences. I told you this before. Don't wait till you're in trouble to have a prayer conference. Hallelujah. Pray while you're happy. Pray while you're doing okay. Pray while everybody got the healing. Pray while he's still blessing. Don't wait for stuff to happen that you all of a sudden want to pray. This lady was desperate. And she saw Jesus in the midst of a crowd. And she said with expectation, if I can just touch the hem of his garment. There was expectation. She didn't care about the law. She didn't care about the police. She didn't care about the folk in church. She didn't care about the priests. She didn't care about the Sanhedrin. She didn't care about the Pharisees. She said, if I can touch the hem of his garment. Expectation of the miraculous. Watch, I know something. You know, when you know that something gonna happen. Robin, you heard me. I didn't say something. But I said something gonna happen. Mother Tima, that's great expectation. That when I go down, something gonna happen to raise me up. Something gonna happen to heal this body. Something gonna happen, Sister Daisy, to bring the deliverance that I need. Something gonna happen, because the God I serve is still the God of the miraculous. Expectation of the miraculous. you got a homework assignment. I want you to spend time this week in the Word of God, finding all 43 miracles of Jesus. Because faith comes by hearing the Word of God. When you find it, read it out loud to yourself. I declare some gonna happen for you. I'm finished, but I ain't done. May the Lord bless you this week. May the Lord keep you this week. Take time. Sit and ponder. Expect the miraculous from God. When the church really begins to believe again, the quickest way the devil got to us was he made us religious, you all. We're no longer relational. We're no longer having expectation. And we went from here to flatline. If the choir don't sing that well that Sunday, oops. You got to go home and get back on the TV or go to somebody else's church to get your groove on. If the pastor don't hit it that Sunday, can I help you? He ain't always going to hit it. He goes somewhere else because you had no expectation of what God might do for you or through you on that Sunday morning. Stop putting it on the preacher. Stop putting it on the pastor. Have some expectation. You know, I'm always talking to you about shouting. And one Sunday we're going to have a shouting service. Can I help with the prophetic word? Because that shouting service will release some of you. It will release you. And hear the word of the Lord. He says you're not too old, nor are you too young. I'm not asking you to be emotional. I'm just asking you to shout to God. His expectation. That's why the psalmist wrote it. Clap your hands, all you people, and shout to God with a voice of triumph. Our religious church made us quiet. We thought that was holiness. I didn't see that in the Word of God. Isaiah said when he got the glimpse, folk was flying around the house declaring, holy, holy, holy. But we got religious. Shh, child, be quiet. Phones make more noise than we do. I like that one. That was pretty good, actually. Y'all didn't. Expect the miraculous. Here's the record book. Find it. Let it make you excited again. Let it make you relational. You wonder about your fire. What happened to the fire? It's still there. Because God's fire can't be put out. Do you hear me? The Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you on this Sunday. Wake up tomorrow if he allows you. Not sorry. Go to bed tonight and expect the miraculous. Amen. For those of you who don't know him, I'm not asking you to become religious. I'm asking you to become relational. Can I help you with relationship? Relationship is life. So in life, you get the good and you get the bad of it. But you get a God who will go with you all the way. Because he's got this. And you are still his this today. If you don't know him, we invite you to know him. How? Just say yes today. Just ask him to come into your heart today, and you come to his heart today. There's an exchange. Because as much as you expect from God, he expects from you. So on today, if you don't know him, come on and say yes. To the little of you who are watching us on Facebook Live, come on and say yes to him today. Give him your heart and get his heart today. I'm going to ask you to stand all over the house. Amen. This is the invitation. If you don't have a church home, if you don't know the Lord Jesus, like you really want to know him, we invite you to know him today. If you've been religious and you want relational, come on and say, today I want to make a change. Come on, come on, come on, come on. If you don't know who he is, come on. If you've never said yes, come on. Are you here today? For those of you watching us on Facebook Live, would you come today? Hallelujah, in your home. Just say yes today. Are you here? I'm looking for a miracle. Will you come? I don't care how long you've been in church. If you really don't know him, won't you come? If you've never said yes to him, won't you come today? Will you come today? Won't you come? Come on, the sky is the limit, the word you can have, yeah. The sky. The sky is the limit to what I can have, oh, yeah. Just believe and receive, oh yes. God will. He wants to perform it in you today. Won't you come, won't you come, won't you come? Come on, if you don't know him, won't you come? Just believe and receive. Do this for those of you, who are watching us on Facebook Live. You might have said yes today. You might have chosen that you're going to take Christ as your Lord and Savior. I want to lead you in prayer. Maybe you're here in the sanctuary and you're struggling, you're wrestling. You know, you would have to say yes to Jesus to be saved. You cannot inherit your mother's or father's salvation. You have to say yes to him. And you have to do it, watch, I'm sorry, but you have to do it publicly. Because Jesus don't have no secret service. He got sacred service. So if you don't know him, if you've never said yes, I want you to pray this prayer. Just pray this prayer with us. Every heart praying, every heart believing. God, repeat this after me. God, here I am. I need to be saved. I've done some bad stuff. please save me now. You said if I come to you, you won't cast me away. So here I am now. I believe your word. I confess Jesus as my Savior. I give you my heart to take your heart. In Jesus' name. And God, I'm sorry for all that I've done. Thank you now for receiving me. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, today is your day. What is the day? May 1st. Oh my gosh, it's May 1st. It's May 1st. The first day of your life, May 1st. If you prayed that prayer on Facebook, if you prayed that prayer, today is the first day of your life. All that you did has been washed away by the blood of Jesus and has been covered by the love of Jesus, because there ain't no sin that the blood can't cover. Amen. And there ain't a sin that the blood can't wash away. God bless you. Y'all put your hands together and give God praise in here. God bless you. Call a church. Call the greater. Call the pastor. Tell your neighbor, thank God that you were saved on today. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen. I now have the privilege of bringing our announcements. Well, we want to keep the celebration going. As Pastor said, today is the 1st of May. It's the first Sunday, and so we'd like to acknowledge all of our Mayites. If you have a birthday in May, please stand up. Woo, please woo, stand woo. Up. Woo. Amen. One of our stewards, our pastor steward, Sister Leslie Foster, today is her birthday. So happy woo, birthday, Lely. Happy birthday, Auntie Lely. And for others who are celebrating this month, we'd like to say Brendan will be celebrating his birthday this week today. And Elton back there will be celebrating. So to our Mayites, we'd like to say, stand up, Mayites. Stand up, Mayites.
Day to, may the good Lord.
Into his word, he forgot to stand up for this month.
No,
of course,
didn't.
We'll be acknowledging him later, but Pastor's birthday is the 17th. So heads up, Pastor's birthday is this month on the 17th.
Y'all get that day off. Praise God. Tell your boss.
Amen. Amen. We'd like to invite you to join us Monday through Saturday at noon for our hour of prayer, and that's via the phone. And so that dial-in number is 313-246-9552. Again, Monday through Saturday at noon is our hour of prayer, and that is phone-in, and that number is 313-246-9552. Our Bible study is on Wednesdays, and we have two, 10:30 a.m., that's virtually and in person here at the Greater, and at 6:30 virtually via Zoom. That meeting ID is 861-3619-8112. 861-3619-8112. And if you dial in, you use that, you would dial in to 312. It covered up my. You would dial in 312-626-6779, enter that meeting ID, and there is no passcode. So through your smart device, again, it's just 861-3619-8112. And if you're calling in, it's 312-626-6779. If you want to be connected through text message with the greater, you can text GQC to the numbers 84576. Again, to be connected via text, you want to text the letters GQC, which are the letters for Greater Quinn Church, to the numbers 84576. We also want to acknowledge any anniversaries this month, whatever anniversary you may be celebrating, we celebrate with you, and we congratulate you on celebrating that moment. Sorry about that. Missionary Annual Day will be May 15th during our 11 o'clock service here in the greater. Our sisters have planned a wonderful celebration. Please join us in person or just join us via Facebook Live. We'd also like to extend the opportunity to bless the greater financially. If you're here in the church, the basket or the box is back there. And if you're on with us virtually, you can always mail it in. The address is 13501 Rosa Parks Boulevard, Detroit, Michigan, 48238. Again, 13501 Rosa Parks Boulevard, Detroit, Michigan, 48238. Or you can always drop it off. Or for those who are tech savvy, we have Cash App, and it's $ Greater Quinn. PayPal, our email address, gqame@sbcglobal.net, or Givelify with just the words Greater Quinn. Again, Cash App, $ Greater Quinn. PayPal, gqame@sbcglobal.net. Givelify, just Greater Quinn. We love you, we praise God for you, and we expect that you were blessed on day, and we expect that you will continue to be blessed in the name of Jesus. Oh, I did forget one thing, sorry. For you watching virtually, you can go do something else. This is for in-house. It was brought to our attention in choir rehearsal on Tuesday that on first Sundays, we want to be reminded that communion is a sacred service. So where it's okay to greet people, we don't want to be visiting during communion. We want to be quiet. We want to be mindful of the sacrifice that he provided us to make it possible to come to him through the throne of grace. So again, we can greet each other, but we can't be talking, we can't be visiting, can't be cracking jokes. It's a sacred service, and we want to govern ourselves accordingly. So we love you. We thank you for adhering to that request, and we pray that you receive it in the way that it's offered. Got nothing but love.
Amen. If stewardesses would come at this time. To those of you who are watching on Facebook Live, God bless you. We're about to go into our communion service. To those of you who are sitting here, you know we will commune them first, and then we'll get to the house in just a few minutes. You might want to prepare yourself at home, amen, with your juice, your wine, your bread, amen, as we prepare to honor the Lord. Out of all that we've done today, Jesus said, didn't say for Blake to get up and preach, didn't say for the choir to get up and sing, Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me. And so we stand today to give honor to the Lord and to remember that night, remember that moment, amen, where he established us, the church, in that upper room. Amen. Praise God. As we prepare our hearts for the prayer of general confession, are we washed? Let us all pray, and let us all learn and pray. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with heart of repentance and true faith turn unto you, have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and lead us to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom our hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. It is it's the right thing to do, y'all. That's what we're really saying. It's the right thing to do that we give thanks, we give praise to our God all the time, evermore, everywhere, to the Holy Father, to the everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, with everybody, we laud and magnify your holy name, evermore praising you and saying, holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord Most High. Amen. Father, we don't presume to come to this your table, but we do come with expectation. Expectation of ourselves that we're nothing more than sinners saved by grace. Expectation to know, dear God, it's by, hallelujah, your mercy that we're even able to walk through the doors today and that it suits our case. And so, Heavenly Father, we pray that right now, God, that all that you've poured out upon us, you would grant us to eat this bread and to drink this juice in the precious name of Jesus, that our sinful souls and bodies may be made clean by your death and washed through your blood, and that we may ever dwell in you and you in us. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your great mercy did give your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death on the cross for our redemption. This is the story. Who made thereby his oblation of himself once offered a full and perfect and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. He became the high priest. He became the lamb. He gave himself up for us, you all, that we might continue to do this, that we might continue to remember how great he is, how precious his death is until he comes. Oh God, we thank you for hearing us on today. And we ask that you, dear God, hallelujah, allowing us to take of this bread and of this juice according to your Savior, Jesus Christ, which is the symbol of his body, which becomes an institution for us, that right now, hallelujah, we would proclaim his goodness because of his love for us in these elements. Heavenly Father, who in the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread, he blessed it, broke it, gave it to his disciples, said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, drink all of it. It's my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink it in remembrance of me. To those of you who are watching us on Facebook Live, you are at home, wherever you are. You might be in a hospital room. We're asking you to take your bread and eat in Jesus' name. Then take the juice, the symbol of the blood of Jesus, and drink in Jesus' name. We pray your healing. We pray that you would have expectation of what the Lord wants to do in your life on this day, in your homes, wherever you are. Expect God to do for you in a miraculous way. Let's pray. God, in the name of the Lord Jesus, through the power of your shed blood, we thank you for this moment of the miraculous. Calvary, miraculous. The grave, miraculous. Resurrection, miraculous. And now Jesus sits as a king, miraculous. God, pour out upon your people who are watching right now, who are listening right now. Pour out upon your people, pour out in their homes, the miraculous. Let there be an expectation that God, not only can you do it, but you will do it in the name of the Lord Jesus. Come on, pour out today, dear God, the miraculous, that healing comes. Cancel cancer, knock out pneumonia, lock up lupus, conquer COVID in the name of Jesus. Diminish dementia in the precious name of Jesus. Do you, God, in the lives of your people today, in the precious name of Jesus, we pray. God, we believe it so. We say yes, and we say thank you, and we say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you on this afternoon. To those who are watching us right now on Facebook Live, we pray that the Lord will continue to bless you, keep you in his word, watch over you, seal you by his spirit, baptize you with fire, fill you with the Holy Spirit, anoint you with his power, fill you with his love, that his angels of safety and protection would be around about you, and you would be covered with the blood of Jesus. Until next week, amen. Next week, Mother's Day, next week, amen. Come on and be with us. Facebook Live, the greater, amen. The Lord's willing and the creek don't rise. We'll be here in Jesus' name. God bless you. God keep you. I'm Pastor Robert Blake. Amen.